Good morning, students. Let's see about part 2 of quality control now. The content of today's discussion is quality control test for closures and secondary packing materials. Closures and secondary packaging materials. In the last class, we have discussed about containers. Now, closures and secondary packaging materials. You know about what is quality control as per WHO. It is the part of GMP concerned with sampling, specification and testing and with the organization, documentation and release procedures to ensure that the necessary and relevant tests are actually carried out and the materials are neither released for use nor products are used for sale and supply until their quality has been satisfactory. There are 8 number of tests for closures, quality control tests for closures. What are those? Sterility test, fragmentation test, self-sealability, pH of aqueous extract. Sterility, fragmentation, self-sealability and pH of aqueous extract. And 5th one, light absorption test, reducing substances test, then residue on evaporation and penetrability. This is the procedure for given for preparation of sample solution before going on to quality control test for closures. First, wash closure in 0.2% weight by volume solution of anionic surfactant for 5 minutes. Then rinse 5 times with distilled water. Add 200 ml water. Further subject it to autoclave and covering with aluminium foil. Allow it to cool and separate solution from closure. And this solution is carried for quality control test for closures. The first one is sterility test. Closures are subjected for sterilization by autoclaving at 64 to 66 degrees Celsius and pressure at 0.7 kilopascal. Further testing is carried out by using culture media. Coming to fragmentation test, take 12 clean vials and place closures containing 4 ml of water. Then allow it to stand for 16 hours. Use hypodermic needle to inject 1 ml of water into the vial and remove 1 ml of air. Carry this operation for 4 times with new needle each time. Pass the water present in vial through a filter with pore size of 0.5 micrometer. Number of fragments of closure retained should be as per the limits. Number of fragments not more than 10 in case of butyl rubber. Number of fragments for other rubbers not more than 15. Coming to self-sealability test, fill 10 vials with a nominal volume of water and place closures. Pierce cap for 10 times at different sites with a hypodermic needle. Immerse vials in 0.1% weight by volume solution of methylene blue under pressure. Keep the container immersed for 30 minutes. Wash the vials and none of vials should contain traces of color solution. What color solution? Methylene blue color solution. Coming to the test for pH of aqueous extract, take 20 ml of sample solution and add 0.1 ml of bromothymol blue. Add 0.01 molar sodium hydroxide till the color change from blue to yellow. Volume required is measured. Volume of sodium hydroxide should not be more than 0.3 ml. If hydrochloric acid is used, then it should not be more than 0.8 ml. Coming to light absorption test, it must be done within 4 hours of preparing sample solution. It is filtered and its absorption is measured at 220 nanometer to 360 nanometer. In UV range, it is analyzed. Blank is done without closure and absorbance must be not more than 2. Coming to the test for reducing substances, 20 ml of sample solution and 1 molar sulfuric acid is taken at 20 ml of sample and 0.002 molar potassium permanganate. Both the solutions are boiled 3 minutes and cool it. Add 1 gram of potassium iodide and treat the solution with sodium thiosulfate using starch solution as indicator. Blank titration is done and difference of sample and blank should not be more than 0.7 ml. Difference should not be more than 0.7 ml. So you are adding with sulfuric acid and potassium permanganate, then adding potassium iodide, sodium thiosulfate is the titrant. It is like oxidation titration method. Coming to 7th test, that is residue on evaporation. 50 ml of sample solution is evaporated at 105 degrees Celsius and residue obtained should not be more than 4 mg. Then coming to penetrability test, this is to measure the force required to make a hypodermic needle penetrate easily through closure. The piercing force must not exceed a stated value. The hypodermic needle can get damaged as a result of undesirable hardness of closure. It is measured by using piercing machine. machine. Now moving on to quality control tests for secondary packaging materials. What are secondary packaging materials? Papers and boards, cottons, corrugated fiber board. Then general tests for secondary packaging materials are the test pieces of paper or board taken for test to be carried in standard conditions. Temperature should be 23 degrees Celsius plus or minus 1 degree Celsius. Relative humidity should be 50% and plus or minus 2%. What are the tests are carried out for paper and board? Means moisture content, folding endurance, air permeability, tensile strength, stiffness and burst resistance. And these are some specific tests for paper and board: dimensions, grammage, read the procedure and you can understand the explanation. And the physical dimension of the given paper board is taken and recorded. Then for grammage test, a test piece of suitable size 10 into 10 cm is cut and weighed. The grammage of the sample is determined by 10 to the power 4 into W divided by A into B. W is weight in grams, A and B are length and breadth. Then test for thickness, measured with a micrometer. Thickness is related to grammage of paper and its bulk density. It directly influences the physical property of paper like stiffness, varnishing and cutting. Then coming to the test for surface pH, acidity in paper may be caused by the presence of residual chemical left in the pulp. A drop of distilled water is placed on the top of the test piece and the electrode of pH meter is placed in the drop touching the paper. The reading is taken after 2 minutes. Then coming to pH after extraction test, cut 1 gram of paper and place it in a 100 ml flask. Fit with a condenser, add 20 ml of boiling distilled water in small portions till the paper is wet. Add 50 ml of distilled water, reflux and digest with occasional shaking at 95 to 100 degrees Celsius for 1 hour. Cool to 40 to 45 degrees Celsius, remove the condenser and shake, cool in water bath, determine the pH of the supernatant with pH meter. Test for moisture content. Conditioned specimen is weighed and heated to a constant weight to expel the moisture. The difference of the two weights gives the moisture content of the paper. Percentage of moisture to be calculated by using 100 into A minus B divided by B. A is original weight, B is weight after drying. And this is the test for ash content. Take about 1 gram of specimen and make it into shreds and place in a previously weighed crucible. Heat carefully over a burner till completely charred. Transfer the crucible into a muffle furnace at 800 degrees Celsius until all the carbonaceous matter are burnt off. Coolant in a desiccator, weigh and repeat the experiment to a constant weight, that is D. So C minus D divided by D is taken. Weight crucible is C, D is constant weight to get percentage ash. Coming to alkalinity test, place about 5 gram of accurately weighed sample cut into pieces in a stoppered flask containing 250 ml of 0.02 normal hydrochloric acid. Allow it to stand for 1 hour with occasional shaking. Decant and titrate a measured quantity that is V against 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide using methyl orange as indicator. Given formula is taken for percentage alkalinity calculation, that is 1250 into B minus E into N divided by V into W. A is sample reading, N is normality of sodium hydroxide. Next test is COP test. This measures the mass of water absorbed by 1 cm square of the test piece in a specified time under a head of 1 cm of water. It is determined by weighing before and after exposure to the water and usually coated in gram per meter square. Coming to test for cottons, compression. This method is used to assess the strength of erected package. And cotton opening force test. The method is used to hold the flat cotton as delivered by its creases between thumb and the first finger press. Then third test is coefficient of friction. Both static and kinetic coefficients of friction are determined by sliding the specimen over itself under specific test conditions. And the next test is crease stiffness. This involves testing a cotton board piece and folding it through 90 degrees. It will then try to recover its position when bending force is removed. Joint shear strength is the method of testing glued lap seam on the side of a cotton for strength of the adhesive using a tensile testing machine. Thank you all for patient listening. These all the tests what we have discussed are very important. Just read twice or thrice to understand the test. It's a simple only, like titration methods, testing, identification test, likewise only. So these are very simple tests to test the secondary packaging materials and closures. Read thoroughly for exams. Thank you so much. In the next class we'll be discussing about good laboratory practices part 1.